Hi, and welcome to the Airbrush Garage. I'm Dan, and thanks for checking out my channel. I'm going to be passing on all the tips, tricks, and accessory builds that I made for my airbrush area in my garage throughout my past 20 years. I know how I struggled when I was a beginner, so hopefully some of my videos may make your life a little bit easier and help you move forward in your airbrushing endeavors. So if you like this content, hit that subscribe button down below. Hit the bell so you don't miss out on future content. So with that, let's get started. Hi, in this episode of the Airbrush Garage, we're gonna be making a car hood holder out of PVC for under $35. It's gonna be easier for you to take that car hood off the car, stick it on your holder, and airbrush away. You're gonna like it, your wife's gonna love it because you won't have a car in the garage. So let's get started. All right, so what you're gonna need for this project is a 5/16 inch drill, a mallet, a hacksaw, and a tape measure. So some basic tools. All the materials on this project are gonna be done with Schedule 40 PVC pipe that you can get at any of your local home centers. So where we're gonna start off, we're gonna build a base first, okay? The base consists of 1¼ by 15 inch piece of PVC. You need one on this side, one on that side, so you need two. Technically, you might as well cut four of them because you need to make a duplicate base. Then it's going to be coupled together by 1¼ T to a 1-inch reducer. I also put some felt strips on the bottom of my base. You could use rubber, felt, whatever you'd like, but you're going to want to do that because it's going to make it sit a lot more stable and make it more slip resistant. Okay, so once you do that, you cut that, mallet them together. I also like to point out, I don't like to PVC mine together because I want to take it apart and store it away in my garage nice and neat instead of having this, you know, out in my garage. So by all means, if you want to cement yours together and keep it permanent, do so. Okay, so the next thing you want to do, again, you want to make two of these, okay? So it's 1 inch by 41 inches long. And I have my adjustment holes drilled in here. That's where the 5/16 inch drill comes in. Now, what you're gonna wanna do is, obviously, from the bottom to the first hole, you're gonna wanna make sure you do the same on your duplicate piece, because these are your adjustment holes. When you put this together, you want that to sit nice and level. So in my case, what I did was I did 3-inch increments on these holes. I went up about 2 feet. I've never adjusted it up that high, but it's there in case you want to. Okay, so anyways, this put together by this 1-inch T reduced to a 3/4 T. The 3/4 T is going to be the receiving piece for the connecting piece that goes between the two stands. Next, you're going to have a 1 inch by 4 inch piece that is going to go into the base. Give it a few taps. Now, you want the 3/4 piece to be at a 90 degree or adjacent to the base, because again, that's gonna serve as your strut. Next, what you got, okay, is your 3/4 piece. It is the only 3/4 piece on the project, but it's 3/4 by 27½. And again, that's gonna serve as your connector piece. You wanna put that in there. You may even wanna lay it down a little bit. Give it a tap or two, make sure it's in. So this other half I have pre-assembled because it's the same as what we just did. Okay. And you want to connect the two. Again, a few taps. All right. The next piece you're going to want to construct is the receiver piece. Okay, the receiver piece is made up of 1¼ by 37½ inch piece of PVC going into 1¼ T coupler that is reduced down to 1 inch. This 1 inch piece of PVC is 6 inches long that goes into a 45 degree coupler with a cap on it. And this is where the hood's gonna sit. Once you have that constructed, slide that over your top. Okay. Then you're going to take your quarter inch pins, okay, with, very important that it has the ring on the end. I did leave out one part. You're going to need to drill a hole in your receiver piece to be able to connect into your adjustment holes. Okay. So you find the hole that you want. Stick your pin in. This is where the bungee cords come in. You want to bungee this back so it's going to be able, because it's PVC, it's not the most sturdy thing in the world, but it's sturdy enough for a car hood. So what you want to do is you want to create some resistance pulling back when that car hood's on with the resistance going forward. So you want to counteract that resistance. So you want to hook it up to that ring on the pin. Come on back. Just hook it right into the back of your PVC. Once you do that, you're ready for your car hood. So there you have it. Hi guys, thanks for coming by the Airbrush Garage. If you like this video, check out some of my other videos for all your airbrush tune-ups. And if you like content like this, hit the subscribe button down below. Hit the bell so you get future notifications. Share it out with your family and your friends. Really appreciate that. And we'll see you in the next video, and keep on painting.